Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel Biology with Meena Kala teacher. In this class we are going to learn transcription in eukaryotes. In eukaryotes, transcription takes place in nucleus. There are three different types of transcripting enzymes. They are RNA polymerase 1, RNA polymerase 2, RNA polymerase 3. RNA polymerase 1 is responsible for 5.8S, 18S, 28S rRNA synthesis. RNA polymerase 2 is responsible for hmRNA, heterogeneous nuclear RNA, mRNA synthesis. RNA polymerase 3 is responsible for tRNA, rRNA, scRNA, snRNA synthesis. Small nuclear RNA. Here you see RNA polymerase 2 is responsible for hmRNA. Okay, the nascent RNA synthesized by RNA polymerase 2 is called heterogeneous RNA or primary transcript or primary transcript. So this primary, what is primary transcript? That is heterogeneous RNA, heterogeneous nuclear RNA. This primary transcript is converted into functional mRNA after post-transcriptional process. It involves three steps: capping, tailing, slicing. If you see capping, okay, so in this capping, modification of 5-hRNA, okay, by capping. Modification of 5-end by capping. So this is the first steps in post transcriptional processes. Okay, in this first step, so what is taking place? Capping. So capping occurs at 5-end after the start of transcription. See, here transcription starts immediately, that is capping also started occurring. Okay, so the unusual nucleotide and residue, that is known as methyl guanosine triphosphate. This is unusual nucleotide residue. So methyl guanosine triphosphate is added at 5-end of hmRNA. Okay, so this addition of methyl guanosine triphosphate at 5-end is catalyzed by guanyl transferase enzyme. So here capping is essential. Capping is essential for formation of mRNA ribosome, for formation of mRNA ribosome complex in transcription, translation. Okay, sorry. So that is, capping is important, essential for formation of mRNA ribosome complex in translation. Translation is not possible if CAP is lacking, because CAP is identified by 18S or RNA ribosome unit. 18S or RNA ribosome unit. Okay, so this is capping. Next, if you see, there is tailing. Tailing means, if you see, adding adenylate residue. Adding adenylate residues at 3' end of hnRNA. Okay, adenylate residue, adding adenylate residues at 3' end of hnRNA. This is helped by, it is catalyzed by poly A polymerase enzyme. Poly A polymerase enzyme. Okay, next is splicing. Splicing means what we'll say, that is here tailing, capping, then splicing. So we'll see here. Splicing, if you see, so removal of intron, so that is unwanted base sequence, and joining of exon, useful base sequence, in a defined order. Okay, so this removal of intron is taken place by snRNA, small nuclear RNA, and protein complex. That snRNA and protein complex called as small nuclear ribonucleoproteins. Nucleoprotein, it is SNRNPS. So that is called, that is known as SNAPS. Now you see completely that is hnRNA is processed. Okay, the processed hnRNA is now called as mRNA. So here you see, in this hnRNA, heterogeneous RNA, capping is taken place. Without capping, it cannot be useful for that in translation. So here it is, exon and intron is shown. So after capping, tailing is taken place. Tailing is taking place, that is splicing, this RNA splicing is done. So means the removal of intron is taken place. After doing all these three processes, okay, so completely this hnRNA is converted into mRNA. So means mature mRNA. So it is now, it is transported out of the nucleus to cytoplasm for translation. Thank you, students.